Congrats, Butch0672. Coming to you guys with a short little video right now. I'm going to work in an hour, so just want to kind of get this out of the way. What a win. What a win last night from Philadelphia against the Green Bay Packers. I mean, that was just a fight. You know, because what I've seen from all these teams in the NFL, doesn't matter what kind of team you have on paper, but if you don't have that inner fight and everyone doesn't really pitch into a game, you really could be in serious trouble. And this Eagles team has fought. This team should be 4-0 right now. This team should be 4-0. Unfortunately, we just had some injuries. Unfortunately, we've ran into some, you know, we've lost games by one drop, one possession. It is what it is. With Alshon Jeffrey back in this game last night, opened up a lot for Zach Ertz. The fans wanted, and I think all of us wanted, Jordan Howard to get more carries, and he did. Miles Sanders looks better each week after having two fumbles last week against the Lions. Defensive line had some pressure. The best pressure I've ever seen from this team this year. And hopefully it carries on. The secondary is depleted and more depleted as usual. We're even probably the thinnest I've ever seen a position. Avonte Maddox ended up on a stretcher. Looked like he was knocked out cold on the field. Anderson Dejo and Avonte Maddox were tackling the same person. And, you know, Anderson Dejo pretty much hit Avonte pretty damn hard while tackling the same guy. Ended up on a stretcher. The news came out last night that he is moving his whole body. He's fine. He's fine. Like, he's moving his whole body. He's getting up. He's fine. The only problem is they just sent him to the hospital. Not really a problem, but they sent him to the hospital. And, you know, they're just sending him to the hospital for further evaluation. That's all that is. I just don't see Avonte Maddox playing next week. Probably not going to play next week at all. He took a really big hit. So the Eagles put in practice squad corner Craig James. And he was the one that, you know, the last play, Aaron Rodgers threw the ball. And, you know, Craig James pretty much, you know, took the hands away from the receiver when the ball got there, tipped in the air, and Nigel Brown got the interception and closed the deal last night. We're really thin. All you have is Rasul Douglas and practice squad corner Craig James on this roster. Sidney Jones got a hamstring today. What else is new? Jalen Mills is still on the PUP list. Won't be back till week 8. Cravon LeBlanc won't be back till week 8. As of right now, Ronald Darby's out for a few more weeks, which we're 13-3. 13-3 when Ronald Darby doesn't play in the Eagles secondary. What a shame. What a big shame that is. And I don't care. The Eagles need cornerbacks. And they need them pretty badly. Malcolm Jenkins was even asked at the post-game press conference after the game and pretty much was like, you know, okay, we have more corners hurt. It's nothing new to this Philadelphia Eagles team. It's nothing new that we have injuries and guys just get in there. You know, if your number's called, you get in there and you make plays and you do what you got to do to win. So the Eagles are going to need some cornerbacks. Now, I don't know what's going on. I know I mentioned Jalen Ramsey's name a million times. I think this is something that's closer to the trade deadline than it is now. Jalen Ramsey still does not want to be a Jacksonville Jaguar, has said that he is done. You know, he says he does not. He doesn't know if it's his last game playing in Jacksonville, but he says he wants out. He's pretty much done. It'd be the perfect time to go out and get Jalen Ramsey. But I have a feeling that that might come later. I got a big feeling that this trade will happen, but just not now. And if it doesn't happen with us, it might happen with the Kansas City Chiefs. Probably the only team that really is going to get him that badly. That's only if they trade in the same conference. But I have a feeling right now that there will be a corner getting signed tomorrow, the next day, whatever it is. I feel like there is one guy in particular that I think is going to get signed. And that is the veteran cornerback, Orlando Scandrick, that didn't even make the team, and didn't even look good in preseason at all. We said to ourselves, if Scandrick doesn't sign with another team, Orlando Scandrick will be back with the Philadelphia Eagles. I put $100 on it right now to anybody that Orlando Scandrick will be in an Eagles jersey in the next few days. I put my money on it. The way this secondary looked, you know, I think Avonte Maddox actually looked a lot better, you know, after, like, you know, close to the end of the second half to, you know, the second half looked a lot better. Outside should be his position. Sidney Jones is just I've given up on Sidney Jones. I think I'm pretty much done with Sidney Jones. He's just not doing much for me. Couldn't cover Davante Adams. Couldn't really cover anybody. Okay, and you know what? None of these corners are perfect. I think the more consistent guy you have in this secondary is Avante Maddox. Rasul Douglas, he has his, you know, he's a great tackler. And I know we all agree that Rasul Douglas should not be in the cornerback position. He should be a safety. But the Eagles just don't think he's safety material. I don't know. Ronald Darby's going to be out for another few weeks, which I don't care. He should stay away from this team as possible. And we didn't need him to win this game. And you know what? Don't matter. But put my money on it right now. Orlando Scandrick will be a Philadelphia Eagle very soon. I don't think the trade is going to come right now for Jalen Ramsey, Xavier Howard from the Miami Dolphins. I honestly don't know. It would be nice to get one of those guys. If you can get, especially Jalen Ramsey, you got a shut down corner. The rest of the defense could help the other side, and Malcolm can move all over the field a lot more. Have a more free zone of players that can move around. Problem is, are they going to pull the trigger? And they're going to do it. Is Howie Roseman desperate enough to get it done? So at this point, I don't know what's going to happen, but I put my money out there Orlando Scandrick will be a Philadelphia Eagle. Just got that feeling. Because I totally forgot that he left us. That he didn't really make the team. And, you know, everybody was saying, oh, watch, down the road, we're going to probably end up signing him. Secondary-wise, I have no faith in this secondary right now. I don't. I think our offense can put up points. You know, you got a week and a few days off. You got the New York Jets on Sunday. The Eagles need to do something. Obviously, they're going to do something because they're not just going to. They're going into this next game with two cornerbacks. That's it. And one of them is practice squad. So pretty much you got Rasul Douglas all by himself, all alone. So at this point, Eagles are going to go make a move. Jalen Ramsey would be nice, but probably not something that happens right now. Could happen tomorrow, could happen next week, could happen in 2 weeks, could happen right before the trade deadline, because you know how the Eagles are very, very strong during the trade deadline. But that's really it. I'm happy our team won. I'm glad to show the world that our team has that fight inside, and they don't give up, and they don't just lay down for a team that's so depleted with injury. Sorry. With injuries, to show that on the field. And there'll be excuses in the book, and the referees are horrible. And they're horrible on both sides. I'm kind of really not liking the NFL because they're missing so many calls on it's not just because of against us, but other teams as well. So other than that, that's really all I have for you. So let me know in the comment section below what you guys think about that. Orlando Scandrick will be a Philadelphia Eagle. I'd probably just put my money on it just because, you know. Other than that, I will see you guys later. Shay squad up. Fly, I'll fly.